Hi, welcome to How to Repair. Today we're working on a Beko washing machine that has a non-turning drum. This can either be one of three problems. The motor has gone open circuit, it may need U-carbon brushes, or you may have a problem with a circuit board. Now this machine has had a problem where you have a unique ticking sound when you turn the drum. Now sometimes that can occur from a bra wire, for example, being wrapped around the heating element in the drum, but this is actually a motor ticking noise. And what it basically means is the motor armature, when you spin the motor, the lugs on the armature have actually risen and are cutting into the carbon brushes. Now this machine actually tripped the electricity at one point in the customer's house and they called us out to have a look at it. But also, because the motor was shorting, in other words, sparking very badly on the commutator, it has also caused the motor module to go open circuit as well. This means that there was no voltage going to the motor because it had shorted out and tripped the circuit board as well. So what we're actually going to do is go through the whole process of diagnosing the problem with this machine and also replacing the components and showing you what the faults are. I'm just going to start the machine for you just to show you the motor actually, which is not turning. Press the start on the program. The door lock will energize and it will go into the pumping mode. Doors energized, lock light come on, it's now pumping. But because the motor has tripped the circuit board or taken out the circuit board, you can see there is no motor action whatsoever. So what we're going to do now is disconnect the machine from the electricity supply, disconnect the water and the drainage system, and we'll turn the machine round so we can work on it. So with the power disconnected, we're going to take the back panel off and the lid off the machine. There's a groove at the bottom that slots in. Torque 15 on the lid on this machine. It may vary from model to model. Okay, the first thing we're going to do is remove the motor so I can actually show you the problem with this. Now, just to prove a point, I'm going to take the belt off the machine first and just bring the belt towards you and let it flick off. Now, if we spin the drum is in reasonable, it's got a little bit of bearing wear which you can hear, but our main problem is the commutator. So if I stop this a second, you can hear this distinct ticking noise from the motor. So we need to take the motor off. Now the problem is with these motors is you have four bolts, two at the front and two at the back. The ones at the back are quite difficult to take off. It is quite tricky to get onto these fittings and you will need, I'm using quarter drive socket set with an elbow and this allows me to get into these hard to reach places. Okay, once you've removed the bolts, unplug the motor harness and sometimes you'll find it hard for the motor to come away. So either use a flat blade screwdriver or I've got a special curvature hook which I'm able to put in and just lever the motor towards you on both of the lugs. And then the motor will come away. You can drop the motor down and take it out. Okay, here we have the motor and I'm going to zoom in for you now. But when we spin the motor, you can hear this ticking noise. And let me show you what we mean. Okay, I'm going to rotate the motor around for you. And if you look at the top now, you can hear the first click. This is where the burnt sector of the commutator, which you can see here, one or two of these lugs have risen slightly, only by a couple of thou, but they've risen enough that as it goes round, you can see it actually moving the carbon brush at the bottom. This is what is not meant to happen, and this is causing a great amount of electrical shorting, which has taken out the circuit board. Okay, I thought I'd just quickly take the carbon brushes off. And if you look closely at the side of this carbon brush, you can see bright brass. This is bright because the arcing has come across to the casing. It didn't necessarily cause a short on here, but it may have tracked across onto the casing, causing it to trip the electricity. And this is why I suspect that the circuit board is damaged. So what I'm quickly going to do now is replace the motor on the machine. Okay, here I've got a motor from my workshop, and it's all in perfect condition. It actually came off a WM74155LW. Although it's a different model number to this machine, it is the same motor. Now, we have lots of motors at the website, so do have a look with your full model number. And if the motor is available, we might have a second-hand one, because these new motors are over nearly, well, this is about £180 to buy. And if we've got a second-hand one, you can normally pick them up for about £40 to £60, depending on the motor. So I'm just going to drop that underneath, take it up, it is quite heavy, and I'm going to put the motor on. I won't bore you with the filming, and we'll then have a look at what motor action we have, and we'll also have a look at the circuit board for any problems. Okay, we've put the belt on, and now when we rotate it, you can hear there is no ticking noise anymore. This doesn't necessarily mean that the machine will work, because we need to inspect the circuit board. Now, I know I've done some tests on this already. When I plug the machine in now, the motor still is not turning. There's no point filming it for you. Basically, I turn the power onto the machine, the pump comes on, but yet again, the motor is not turning. And I know that this is a perfectly good motor. Now, if you did have the wiring configuration for this machine, you would be able to actually do a voltage test on two of the terminals on the plug. You would be looking for one going to a carbon brush and one going to a field winding. And when it's doing one rotation, it should have 240 volts. And when it does the other rotation, the other carbon brush and the other field winding will have 240 volts. You can see all about this in our other video on testing motors, workbench testing them. Okay, the first thing we're going to look at here is we have two circuit boards. We have the main program circuit board, which is behind the facial panel. This is not the one on this machine. On this machine, we have a second circuit board here. This is called the motor module or motor printed circuit board. These sometimes can go because they're short on the motor. So we need to remove this to inspect it. There's one screw at the top, which I'll just quickly undo. The circuit board will drop down. Just put the screw safe. I'm going to lift up the circuit board. And the motor, or the plug, which goes to some of those wires go down to the motor, and another one goes to the actual printed circuit board itself. Now, there's a little clip on the circuit board at the bottom. Press that clip, lift up the circuit board, and slide it backwards. And there is our problem. Now, I'll zoom on this for you, but I can see straight away, and here is a clear telltale sign. You can see burning on the plastic in two locations, and if you mark that to where it is on the circuit board, I can see that I have a blown track on this one and a blown track on this one. Okay, if you look closely here, you can see the track that's burnt here and the track that's burnt here. It is possible to repair the board, but the problem being is you may not know which components are actually blown on the board. So we're going to replace this with a new PCB. Okay, on this model of machine, which is a WMB71642W, the circuit board that's required is a 28176901. And this is a new circuit board. And as you can see, we have the new and the old. There may be variations slightly on design depending on when it was manufactured, but you can see the good track on this one and also the good track on this one. And we're going to fit that to the machine, and then we'll be able to put the machine on test. Again, just sliding the circuit board into its location lugs, dropping it down, clip it into place, then dropping that down and refitting the screw that holds the circuit board in place. And now I'm going to drop on the motor connection, or the circuit board connection. And there we go, we're ready to put the machine on test. Okay, the machine's all back together. We've plumbed it in and everything else and connected up all the wiring. So I'm just going to turn the machine on. But the first thing I want to point out to you is, although I've assembled the machine and when I turn the drum now, there's no ticking noise. If I turn the drum fast, I can hear that the front bearing has become noisy. And I was hoping to be able to renovate this machine to sell to someone who needed a machine in the local community. Because the bearings are not very good, I'm not going to be doing this. So you're going to be able to obtain some bargains for this because I will put all the parts after I've dismantled the machine on the website for you. But I wanted to show you the whole machine working, and I'm going to turn it to the spin cycle, turn the machine on. And as we did before, the program will come on. I'm going to press the start button. And first thing you will hear is the door clicking. There was the door clicking. The pump comes on, as it did before, but now in a second you will see some motor action taking place. This means that the machine would have been perfectly fixed, but because of the drum bearings, I'm going to actually dismantle this machine, because this is another prime example of manufacturers building built-in obsolescence into the machines. This is a sealed drum. And for the sake of a 5-pound bearing, which I would have been able to replace, I am only able to replace the whole drum. And this is such a waste in society. All the manufacturers are doing this today, and it is just sheer built-in obsolescence. I hope you found this video helpful. Please remember to subscribe to our channel, as that's what keeps us going and able to make these videos for you. And I'm quickly going to turn that off because you don't want to hear how bad the bearings are. There are other videos on this machine with regards changing the pump, changing the belt, changing actually the drum as well. And all the parts that I take off this machine will be on the website available for sale. Thanks very much indeed for watching.